What is the best weapon to use for DPS in Destiny 2 PvE right now? Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nychronic Heroes here on this Destiny 2 video where we're going to be talking about exactly that, counting down the top 5 weapons for PvE destruction. And of course, if you do end up liking this video, make sure you leave a like down below and subscribe for more top 5 Destiny videos in the future. Without further ado, let's get right into it. Coming up at number 5 in the top 5 DPS weapons in Destiny 2 is going to be the exotic shotgun called the Acrius. Now, this is going to be that raid shotgun that everyone knows and loves. If you want to know how to get it, it's basically a raid quest line. You can look up many videos online on how to get it. It's very popular, very common. When you first get it, it does start off with one shot in its magazine. Of course, once you do upgrade it, it does go up to 2, which makes its DPS a lot more effective. Now, what makes this weapon so great is that it's just an incredibly powerful shotgun. Imagine a single shotgun in the game that reloads very, very slowly. They gotta add a lot of power to it. Not only that, it overpenetrates target, which means it'll pierce through every target that's right in front of you up to a certain range and destroy all of them at the same time. Now, throughout this whole top 5, we'll be referencing their DPS on the dogs in the Leviathan raid because it is the best measure of DPS on a static target. Now, if you're going to use this weapon on the dogs, I recommend headshotting them the whole time, and you should be able to use all of your shots. I believe there's 7 shots in it. Very quickly, you can basically release all of them within like 10 to 15 seconds, which makes it really nice because then you can use all of your ammo and then run back to the safe house before anything bad happens. In that time, again, you'll be doing incredible amounts of damage. The only downside, obviously, the fact that you have to reload, and reload is very slow, as well as the fact that when you pick up a power brick, it is only one shot, very similar to a rocket, so every time you shoot, you have to pretty much guarantee yourself you're doing enough damage that is similar to amount that a rocket launcher can do. But overall, it is a very underrated weapon, and I recommend you giving it another try. Coming in at number 4 in the top 5 DPS weapons is going to be the legendary shotgun, the Hawthorne shotgun, otherwise known as the Hawthorne Field Forge. Now, this is the fast fire rate shotgun you can get from Hawthorne in her legendary engrams, her clan XP engrams, as well as from New Monarchy, I believe, has in their pool of weapons. So when the next faction rally comes out and you want to get this weapon, go to New Monarchy. They have the best shaders anyways. Go do their quests, get a lot of engrams for them, and you should be able to get the Hawthorne's Field Forge shotgun pretty quickly. I know the last time that I turned in 30 of those engrams, I think I had like 4 or 5 left over. Now, most people use this weapon in PvP, but this weapon has incredible DPS with an incredible fast fire rate. Again, very similar to the Acrius, we can just basically dish out all the damage onto those dogs very quickly, very fast, and be able to do it very quickly to go back to the safe house before having to shoot all your shots, unlike a rocket launcher, which would take a lot longer to get rid of all your shots. It's also very effective against random different mobs. You can kill hobgoblins, cabals, even those orange health and yellow health enemies. They're very effective against them, since you have 7 shots in a clip. You can pretty much decimate any one of those guys as long as they're not like a public events boss. It is very effective and very nice. Obviously, it is a shotgun, so it has a limited range and it cannot be used on Kallus or Argos. Coming at number 3 in the top 5 DPS weapons in Destiny 2 is going to be the Wardcliff Coil. Now, a lot of people would disagree with this pick, but I'm going to tell you why I find this so very effective when I'm doing the raid, doing the Nightfall, and in general fighting enemies with a lot of health. So yes, I agree, this weapon is not exactly a boss killer. It's not effective against Argos, the dogs, or even Kallus. It's just not effective against those big bosses, but it is effective against those kind of smaller bosses. Those guys with the orange bars or the yellow bars, for some reason, this weapon excels at destroying them. Not only that, if you kill these guys in one shot, like the flamers in the raid, the last part in the raid where those little flamers come out with the big shields or the centurions, this weapon usually destroys them in one shot. Once you do destroy them, you can walk over their body and pick up the power brick and automatically load that into your ammo reserve, stopping you from having to do a reload, which is the most cumbersome part about this weapon. So in general, it might not be one of those boss killing weapons, but it is very effective at killing those big mobs as well as killing a whole blanket amount of enemies. If you have a whole bunch of enemies in front of you, little ones, you can basically destroy them all in one shot or one sweep. You can literally click it and then drag your scope over to the side and blanket an entire area with bombs on it, and it is so fun to use, so effective. Coming in at number 2 in the top 5 DPS weapons in Destiny is going to be the exotic fusion rifle called the Merciless. Now, this is a very well-known weapon for its DPS. It shoots faster every time it hits an enemy and does not kill them, so you have all 8 shots in a clip. If you're shooting a boss like Kallus, or even like a public events boss, or anything like that, you can basically shoot all of those shots very, very quickly. Every time you hit the enemy and you don't kill it, it will charge up faster and faster and faster every time, which makes your DPS incredibly quick. Again, with the dogs in the Leviathan raid, it is very effective at killing them because of the fact they don't move. You can get those headshots, which I believe it has a headshot damage increase on it, and you can do it very quickly. They're standing still. You can get all your shots on target. They have a big broad body. Should be very effective at doing incredible DPS. Very similar amount of damage to the Hawthorne as well as the Accurate Shotgun in this sense. Of course, at the same time, you can also use it at mid-range, which makes it effective against Kallus. However, against Argos, because he's so far away, you'll actually have damage drop-off. This weapon can be found in general exotic engrams, similarly the Warcliff as well, but this one is sold quite often by the Xur. I think he's sold it 2 or 3 times by now, so make sure you pay attention to what the Xur is selling every week. I make a video every week about what the Xur is selling right at that 9 a.m. on Friday, so make sure you go check those out to make sure you can get yourself a Merciless when it is out. As well as shout out, the Colony is being sold this week, so if you haven't gotten it, go make sure you go get the Colony, because it's an amazing grenade launcher. And finally, coming in at number 1 for the top 5 DPS weapons in Destiny 2, most people know it, understand it, and love it. It actually has a twin weapon on it. I'm talking about the Sins of the Past Raid Legendary Rocket Launcher, as well as the Legendary Rocket Launcher from the Vanguard, the Curtain Call. Now, I know that was a bit of a mouthful because I was kind of jumbling it up, but basically the Sins of the Past and the Curtain Call, very similar weapons in some aspects and can be used in many different scenarios, and you can actually switch them out because they have their advantages in each of their different realms. So starting off, the Sins of the Past is going to be that Raid Rocket Launcher, which is a cluster bomb rocket launcher, both cluster bombs, which is why it makes it so effective, is that Raid Rocket Launcher you can get in the raid. For some reason, this weapon just does incredible damage. It has maximum blast radius, so if you're trying to hit a lot of enemies, you'll hit the biggest amount of blast radius, as well as all of the cluster bombs will start to go every which way, which makes it very effective at covering an entire area, very effective against a lot of little enemies, as well as some general orange health enemies and yellow bar enemies. It's very effective against bosses because it's a rocket launcher and it doesn't have any range penalties on it. You can hit Argos, you can hit the dogs, you can hit everybody, and it's very effective against Kallus. It's a very fun weapon to use. Not only that, its handling is pretty high, so it makes it very effective in PvP as well as being able to shoot it very quickly when there's a bunch of enemies behind you. On the flip side, the Curtain Call is a legendary rocket launcher from the Vanguard. It has a low handling, which makes it less effective at shooting while running away, less effective while playing in PvP, as well as the fact that the blast radius is not as big. However, it makes up for that in the faster reload speed, as well as the faster velocity. It also has less stability, but on a rocket launcher, who cares about stability? It just doesn't matter. As well as the fact, for some reason, the Sins of the Past also has a lot better aim assist, so if you're trying to hit lots of little enemies, it might help you out. So in general, I would say Curtain Call is a lot better for PvE stuff when you're using it against like Argos and Kallus, but in general, other than the big boss stuffs, I would say in general PvE, I would like the Sins of the Past, and that is why I use the Sins of the Past more often than the Curtain Call, just because it's not very convenient to have to jump in the air and wait such a long time for that handling to catch up for you and having to fire those rockets, is why I much prefer the Sins of the Past over that, which is very effective. Anyways, that's pretty much the video for guys today. I hope you guys did enjoy that top 5 rundown. I tried to make it as short as possible without rambling too much, but as well at the same time give you the information that you need. Let me know in the comments down below what weapons that you thought were the best weapons, the best DPS weapons in general, as well as let me know if I made a mistake about this. Let me know how I can improve in the future, and of course let me know what you think of the top 5, because I'd love to do more of these in the future. A bunch of random ones, not just on weapons, maybe like random concept art or like the top 5 lore things. I don't know what I should do, but let me know in the comments down below what you guys have an idea about. Anyways, I've been Dakronic. I hope you guys did enjoy, and I'll see you guys on the next one.